I'm going to demonstrate here how to use PolyMath to carry out nonlinear regression to determine the kinetic parameters in the Michaelis-Menten kinetics expression. Two parameters are maximum rate and Km, where S is the substrate concentration, that's our independent variable. V is the velocity or the rate of reaction, or dependent variable. I'm going to use the data from this reference, and I'm using it in the same format, so S is in micromoles, but obviously this would be per some volume, and just to be consistent with the reference, I'll use it this way. And so what I'm going to determine is both the parameters and the confidence limits. So let's look at what the results are, and then we'll go to the PolyMath program. So here are the parameters. Notice that the confidence limits are a small fraction, particularly for Vmax of the value. The R squared value is large. Variance is relatively small. And if we look at a plot, which I'll show you here, I'm plotting the rate versus S, substrate concentration. And the data are just the green squares. The fit is the blue. Now this is, rather than drawing a curve for the equation, this is just an Excel connecting the dots. So that's why it's not a smooth curve. But you can see the fit is really very good for nonlinear regression. And we show another screencast if we were to use the Lineweaver-Burk linear regression approach. We wouldn't get a very good fit to the data. So let's go and look at the PolyMath program. So here's the PolyMath program. What I've already done is I went in the program and selected the regression. And now we select nonlinear regression. I'm going to copy the data. So it's data from a spreadsheet. And I copied into the program, and then I'm going to label the column. So I go to CO1, and that's the substrate concentration. And then CO2, the second column, is the rate. So let's call it V, since that's the notation we use in Michaelis-Menten. Now, I'm going to do a regression. So to do a nonlinear regression, on the right, I selected nonlinear regression. I have to input the model. So V is equal to V max, that's my first parameter, multiplied by S, and then divided by Km plus S. So you'll notice that PolyMath shows immediately the two parameters, because in nonlinear regression, I have to estimate the value. So let's try 1 and 400, since I have some information about what I expect the answer to be. And if the guess is too far off, the regression is not going to work. I can get output of the residuals, a report. Let's just look at those two for now. I've already showed you the graph of the fit. So if I select this purple arrow, it regresses, gives us the parameters 544 for Km, 0.3767 for the max. R squared is pretty large. And if we look at the residuals, so the residuals, of course, are the difference between the experimental values and the values from the model. And distribution looks random. We can calculate the run number, which we've described in other screencasts, but let me bring up those results. So the run number is just the residuals, which is in the last column here, the delta, difference in the rates measured and calculated. And every time there's a sign change, that's a new run. So this is 1, the first data point, then it's negative for two values. That's 2, plus again is 3, negative, that's 4, and then plus again is 5. We expect approximately 6 for a random distribution. This number 10, number of data points divided by 2 plus 1. So this indicates that this is a reasonable fit, that there's not some pattern. And so this demonstrates how quickly we can do nonlinear regression with PolyMath to get kinetic parameters.